Hello everybody, Kelsey the Pyrofly here, and today I am playing another puzzle map, and as you can see behind me, this one is called Lady and the Tiger. And I just want to say thank you to everybody who watched my last puzzle map video. It was the singular cube one. That is literally the most views I've ever gotten on any video in my whole life. So that was awesome, and since a lot of people watched, I decided that a puzzle map would probably be a good idea. So here I am playing another one. This map is made by Brosiest, and as I said before, it is called Lady and the Tiger. And I believe that this is based on a short story that I had to read in English class in 7th grade. Yeah, that's what we're talking about here. And if I recall, there was this guy, okay? And this guy basically ended up having this choice between two doors. Behind one was basically his girlfriend, who I believe was a princess, and behind the other was a hungry tiger that would probably not hesitate to murder him on sight. And if I recall, the reader never gets to know which door he chose, so you were left in suspense. But don't worry, guys, that will not be an issue with this map. From what I've heard, I will know whether I passed the test or failed miserably, and you guys will get to know as well. My money is on miserable failure. I'm gonna say if I can get better than 50%, today is a success. So we're just gonna get this thing started. One day, a king read The Lady or the Tiger by Frank Stockton. All right, there's the author. I told you it was a story. See, it's in quotes. That means short story. I was right. My memory is like on point right now. Okay, so the king is reading the story. Do I need to, like, do something? Why is nothing happening? Oh, I bet I have to click this, don't I? Man, these click events get me every time. Yes, let's continue. This gave him what he thought was an excellent idea, which is probably going to turn out horrible. this is a perfect way to try my YouTube prisoners. Only, I won't leave it to chance. Oh, really? Okay, so yeah, in the book, it was like a 50-50 chance of live or die. But in this case, what's the deal? I'll have signs on the doors of the rooms. What's, like, one's gonna say lady and one's gonna say tiger? But it's not that easy, is it? And in each case, I'll tell the prisoners certain facts about the signs. If the prisoner is clever and can reason logically, he'll save his life and win a nice bride to boot. Excellent idea. Yeah, if you're not the prisoner, I'd be a little upset if I were the prisoner. Okay, let's see. If I keep pressing, yeah, okay, I think we're done. Trial one, Dan TDM's trial. And by the way, guys, you know, first, let's turn off auto jump because it's already driving me insane and it's only been like 2 minutes. But I really hope this doesn't really require me to know anything in particular about the YouTubers, because if it does, I am a complete lost cause because I live in a hole and I only watch like 2 YouTubers. So yeah, apologies for that. If that's what it is, I'm a goner. But let's just see what these signs say. In this room, there is a lady, and the other room, a tiger. In one of these rooms, there is a lady, and in one, there's a tiger. And what do you have to say to us, Gilbert? Is it true what these signs say? Yeah, I don't know. Should I really trust these signs? It's probably a trick. This is Gilbert. He's going to help us out, hopefully. One of them is true, but the other one is false. I don't suppose you're going to tell me which one, are you? All right, so this one here, in one of these rooms, there is a lady, and in one, there's a tiger. So basically, if this one was false, then that would, like, defeat the whole purpose, right? In one of these, there's a lady, and in one, there's a tiger. If that wasn't true, then, like, the whole premise of the map would be null and void. In this room, there is a lady, and in the other room, there is a tiger. If this one is false, then it just means that I definitely do not want to go in there. So I'm definitely thinking this room is the one for two reasons. First off, it would make no sense if this statement was false, because that would, like I said, that would make no sense with the premise of the map. And also, let's be honest, this is just too obvious. I mean, I get that this is the first level, but I'm going this one. Obvious is almost never the answer in a puzzle map. Alright, did I pass or fail? I guess maybe I do have to be kept in suspense until later. See, did it say? It didn't. The rules may have changed. Please talk to Gilbert for new updates. Okay, I'm... Apparently it's not going to tell me whether I passed or failed miserably. We will find out sooner or later, I think. Sunday says, are the statements on the sign true, homie? I still don't trust them. All right, bro, what's up, Gilbert? Are they true or false? They are either both true or both false. Gosh dang, this is a logic puzzle. This is the kind of thing that makes my brain hurt. Okay, so they're either both true or both false. At least one of these rooms contains a lady. A tiger is in the other room. Okay, so if they're both true, that means one contains a lady and the tiger is in this one. It's reasonably plausible. Now, if they're both false, it means none of the rooms contains a lady. And the tiger is in this one. But since we know that there has to be a lady and a tiger, then at least one of these rooms contains a lady has to be true. Because if it was false, again, it doesn't fit with the premise. So I'm thinking that means it can't be false, so it has to be true. Which means this is true. A tiger's in the other room, which makes the lady in this room. I'm going with this one. Stampy's trial. And again, we need to talk to Gilbert to see what's the deal with these signs. What up, Gilbert? Are these signs telling the truth? They are either both true or both false, once again. So I believe, really, we just have to figure out which one turns out to be completely illogical. All right, this one here. This room contains a tiger. It could be true. Both rooms contain ladies. That could not be true because that is not how the game works, I don't think. So, now if this is false, both rooms contain ladies. That could be false. And this room does not contain a tiger is also a fairly reasonable statement. So since both rooms contain ladies has to be false, that means that this is also false, which means there is no tiger in this room. So we are going to head right into here. Yesterday was a fiasco. Okay, apparently that either means that I failed miserably or nobody died. They really wanted to see somebody get shredded by a tiger. Let's see which one it is. All three prisoners solved their puzzles. Yes! I'm smart! I'm smart, guys! I'm not stupid! Yes! I'm so happy. I'm already, like, beating my highest expectations right now. Well, we have 5 trials coming up today, and I think I'll make them a little tougher. Well, that's a shame, because I like things easy. I do. I really do. Excellent idea! Are you just, like, sucking up to the king? I think you just agreed to everything he says. If you said, let's all go jump off a cliff, I bet you'd agree just to make him happy. I bet you would. You don't seem like a very smart guy. I mean, honestly, I don't think this guy's had anything to say other than excellent idea. But anyway, let's see what's happening. All right, rules may have changed, and we better be talking to old Gilbert. Trial 4, this is Jerome's trial. There's a door here. Apparently, we do not go out that way. What do we have here? We have a very beautiful room. And Gilbert, my main man, what is going on? Do I listen to the signs? I don't know. Do we listen to the signs? Take notes, kid. If a lady is in the left-hand room, aka room 1, then the sign on the door is true. But if a tiger is in it, the sign is false. Okay, brain is in pain. Right, so if a lady is in here, then it's true. Both rooms contain ladies. If a tiger is in here, then it's false. But we know that this is clearly false. It has to be false. So I think that means that a tiger must be in there. Both rooms contain ladies. Well, both of these are false, but it said the left room, right? If a lady is in the left-hand room, then the sign on the door is true. But if a tiger is in it, the sign is false. Okay, so that must mean that... Right, my brain is, like, freezing up right now. This isn't cool. But both rooms contain ladies. That can't be true, so it must be false. But... Okay, then the sign on the door... If a tiger's in it, the sign is false. If it is false, then a tiger is... If it is true, then a tiger is not... Okay, here's the thing. I, remember from geometry class taking a little bit of, like, logic, knowledge, class, things. My brain is in a bad place right now. Don't judge my English right now. We're talking about math! But the thing is, technically speaking, if A then B is not necessarily the same as if B then A. But I'm still thinking that this is false, so I'm thinking that that means that there's probably is a tiger in this room, so I'm just going to go with the right room, but it's... Because I just can't think of any other way to go about it other than assume we're talking biconditional statements here, but I don't know. If I mess up, we'll find out sooner or later. I'm just going with this one. And I don't know. I can never tell if I pass the test or fail. Oh, look, I have a head. I just realized this now. Why do I just realize this now? You know what? Give me this. Give me the shovel. I feel like I need this in my life. I think maybe I will just go and smack Gilbert until he coughs up the information in an easy-to-digest form. Like, just tell me, bro. Tell me which one to go through, left or right. It's that simple, buddy. If you tell me now, I won't hit you with this shovel. Gilbert, answer me. What's the rules with the signs, bro? Same rules as Baca's. If a lady is in the left-hand room... The sign on the door is true, but if a tiger is in it, the sign is false. Okay, are the signs both the same? The other room contains a lady. At least one room contains a lady. All right, let's one more time. If a lady is in the left-hand room, then the sign on the door is true. If a tiger is in it, then the sign is false. If a lady is in the... I think I might have messed up the last one, now that I think of it. I think I actually might have messed it up, but I don't know! I don't know, logic is so hard. Like, I'm like going in mental circles right now, and bad things are happening in my head. I can't think. Right, let's read this one more time. If a lady is in the left-hand room, then the sign on the door is true. But if a tiger is in it, the sign is false. At least one room contains a lady. That is true. The other room contains a lady. That is true. That might be true, but we know this one is true, which means that the lady is in the left-hand room. Okay, I'm thinking left-hand room. Let's go. Actually, I might have gotten the other one right now that I think of it. I don't even know. I just don't know. My brain is in terrible agony because I don't know what I'm doing. Oh man, I forgot to smack Gilbert with a shovel. I'm gonna do it next time, Gilbert. I wasn't joking around, okay? Like, give it to me straight. Which one do I want to go in? What do I do with these signs, dude? Yeah, seriously, what do I do? Ugh, tired of repeating this. If a lady is in the left-hand room, aka room one, then the sign on the door is true. But if a tiger is in it, then the sign is false. Alright, Gilbert. That's it. You're gonna get a beatdown, buddy. Okay, I feel bad. I can't do this. I don't like you, alright? You are a very annoying person. Do you know this? Very annoying. Right. Let's look at our signs. If a lady is in the left-hand room, then the sign on the door is true. So if there's a lady in here, then that means that this is true. It makes no difference which room you pick. That is a lie. If a tiger is in here, then that means this is false. And that's definitely false. Or, you know, honestly, if it was true, then it wouldn't matter. But let's just assume it's false. So I guess the tiger would have to be in here. There's a lady in the other room is also then false. So yeah, this one. I'm thinking this one right here. Preston's trial. Oh, and by the way, guys, I'm talking through my own thought process here. If what I'm saying right now makes any sense to you, you are an incredible person, and apparently you can read minds. If it makes absolutely no sense, forgive me. I am just rambling. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoy at least seeing me horribly confused, because that's what puzzle maps are meant for. Let me guess. Same old rules. Hey, Gilbert, don't be a doodle banger and help me out here. That is what that says, right? Doodle banger. Never heard of such a thing, but whatever. Right. All I can say is what I told the others. If a lady's in the left-hand room, then the sign on the door is true, but if a tiger's in it, the sign is false. Okay, so assuming there's a lady in here, that means this must be true. It does make a difference which room we pick. That is true, which would mean there's... Which makes sense. Now, if this was false, then that would mean this is false, meaning it doesn't make a difference, which obviously is a lie as well. So I'm thinking it must be true and there must be a lady in here. You're better off choosing the other room is also then true. So yeah, I'm thinking everything lines up with true. We get no logical contradictions. And we have Tom's trial. I believe this is the last one for the day. I wonder if I've done it right or if I've failed miserably. Let's see, bro. This room contains a tiger. Both rooms contain tigers. Why are the signs up here? Gilbert, what is going on here? Bro, there are no signs above the door. Seriously, what are you trying to pull on me, Gilbert? Oh, yeah. Haven't had time to put them up yet. Let me guess. We don't know which ones they belong to. Ugh. That's Darude. How do you expect me to choose? Yeah, seriously, bro. How? Well, the signs are here next to me. Yeah. Okay, I see that, but which door do they go to? And you're not going to tell me, are you, buddy? You're not going to say it. Well, if you think about it, I don't need to tell you. Just know that. P.S. This is different from the other rooms. If a tiger is in the left-hand room, then the sign on the door is true. If a lady is in it, the sign's... Oh, you're going to, like, mix it up. You're just trying to, like, turn my brain upside down and twist it in weird shapes. My brain is not meant to do this, guys. This is, like, not supposed to happen. All right. So, right. If the lady is in the left-hand room, then the sign is false. But first, let's see if we can just figure out this room contains a tiger or both rooms contain tigers. Okay, so we're going to have to think of both rooms contain tigers. This is clearly false, which means that one of the doors is false. And from what I've figured from the rest of this, it seems like both signs are either true or false in this instance. So if this is false, that probably means this is false, which means whatever room this thing goes to is the one we definitely want to go to because it containing a tiger is false. Okay, but then does that help me figure out which door is which? Oh, it does, because if the sign on the door is true, if a lady is in it, the sign is false. Okay, so we know both the signs are false. And that means that this sign has to be false, which means it must be on the room with the lady. And since we're talking about the left-hand room, that's the one that has to have the lady. So I'm thinking left-hand room for the win. Come on. Found it! Oh, I think I did it again. I think he's, like, getting really mad now. I think I'm beasting and feasting right now. All five prisoners won! Okay, we are doing amazing. I think I might have already beat my 50% mark. I'm just gonna give myself a quick pat on the back. I think I deserve this. Oh, this is fun. I think tomorrow I'll have three rooms instead of two. You wouldn't dare. That is cruel. Why would you do that? I'll put a lady in one room and a tiger in each of the others. Oh, come on. You just reduced my chance from 50% to 33.333333. Yeah, you get the idea. Then we'll see how the prisoners fare. You're getting very salty about this, aren't you, Mr. King? You want to see some bloodshed. I mean, you are a cruel, cruel man. Excellent idea. You really are just a suck-up, aren't you, Mr. Minister? Have you had an original thought in your entire life? Because I don't think so. Your conversation, though flattering, is a bit on the repetitious side. Okay, apparently I'm not the only one who thinks this. And what kind of conversation is that? You're just saying the same thing over and over. Excellently put. Well, at least he switched it up a little bit. What is wrong with this guy? Right, the rules may have changed. Talk to Gilbert. We know the drill. Wait, did it say whose trial this was? I didn't catch it. Why are there so many villagers? Let me press this. Come on, it's totally a secret Easter egg button that gets you out of here, right? Button, I'm counting on you. I don't want to think. I just want to press this. You know what, button? I'm going to keep hitting you in the face until you do what I want you to do. So you might as well just, like, teleport me out of here now, buddy. Okay, fine. The button's not going to listen. Why am I talking to a button? I think I've been in prison too long and I'm going completely insane. All right, Gilbert, what's up? What context are these signs in? Yeah, what's the deal with these signs? At most, one of the three signs are true. Two doors contain tigers and only one has a lady. Good luck, Mr. Wizard. And what are you guys doing over here? Why are there a bunch of fishermen? I don't know. Okay. To say at most one of the three signs are true. So one may be true, but it's possible that all three are wrong as well. A tiger is in this room. It could be true. A lady's in this room. It could be true. A tiger is in room two. Okay, so if a tiger's in room two, that would make this one false. And that could, but then these two could still technically be true. Let's see, if we assume a lady is in this room, if we assume this is a true one, then that would mean that this one is false, but this one is true, which means, that actually means that this can't be true, because if the lady is in here, the tiger must be in here, but we can't have two true. It said at most, one is true. So we know this one's false. Okay, so if a tiger is in this room, then that can be true, and this could also be true. So a tiger is in room two is fine. So we know that this is not the one we want to go to, because that would lead to an illogical conclusion. But I'm a little stumped on what to do with these two here. A tiger's in this room. Wait a minute. If I say a tiger's in this room, and I assume that's true, that would mean this has to be false. A tiger's in room two. But if a tiger's in room two, and that's false, that means a lady's in this room. We already determined a lady can't be in this room. Which means that this one has to be false, which should mean the lady's in here. And if we did this one as true, tiger's in room two, that would be fine. That would mean the other tiger's in here. I'm thinking it's got to be this one, because this one has to be false. If this is true, it leads to an illogical conclusion once again. Because basically, if this is true, then the other two have to be false, which means this is false, which would make this one true, but they can't both be true, so basically this one's false. There's a lady in this room. We're all good. I think. Alright, trial 10. We have a bunch of villagers here. Apparently they're watching me, hoping that I'm gonna die. Gilbert, what's the deal? What are the rules for these signs, bro? Only one room has a lady, two have tigers. The sign on the door of the room containing the lady is true, and at least one of the other two signs are false. You got this, Brosie. I do not got this, but we're gonna see. What is wrong with this place? Are you guys seeing this? Am I the only one who is seeing this? There is a head in that cauldron. That is mucho disturbing. All right, let's see if we can logic through this. Only one room has a lady, two have tigers. A sign on the door with the lady is true. And at least one of the other signs is false. So if we get to the point where all the signs are true, then we've reached an illogical conclusion. Okay, let's start with this one. Let's assume it's true. A tiger. Well, let's just assume the lady is in this room. If she's in this room. If this is the right door and she's in this room, then this has to be true. So a tiger's in room two. A tiger's in this room. That's fine. That's also true. That means this has to be false. A tiger is in room one. Would be false. And that's fine because we decide the lady is in here. So far it's looking like room one is good. But before I can choose room one, I do have to rule out the other room. So if this is true, if the lady's in here, that means the tiger's in this room is true. That's an easy illogical conclusion. That's a big no. So room two is wrong. A tiger's in room one. If the lady's in here, that means this is true, which means a tiger is in room one. So if the lady's in here, that means the other two have to be tigers, and it means this is true. So a tiger's in room one. A tiger is in room... Okay, now I'm confused. One more time. A tiger's in room one. A tiger is in room two. Wait, would this be right or wrong? Okay, wait, so we know... Okay, going in circles here. We're gonna take it from the top. A tiger's in room one. We know this is true because we're assuming the lady is in here. So that means there's a tiger in here. So the question is, that just means that one of these has to be false. Like, I was doing so good, and then I think my brain broke down really bad. See, a tiger's in room two. A tiger's in this room. Why are you so hard? Okay. A tiger is in room one, so we'd have to assume there's a tiger in here. And then one of these... Okay, a tiger is in room two. A tiger is in this room. That would make them both true. If this was false, a tiger is in room two. A tiger is in this room would also be false. But the thing is, it said... at least one of the other two signs are false. It didn't say they couldn't both be false. Is the problem, but honestly, I'm like super confused. I honestly think room one is the way to go. A tiger's in room two is true, which makes this true, which makes this false, which still makes sense. I honestly think this is the answer. So we're gonna see if I was right on that. I'm not super sure because like my brain got stuck there. Like it seriously started seizing up. That's what happens when I think too hard. But I think I might have gotten that one. So let's see, Gilbert, what's the deal here? Hey, man, what is the deal with these signs? Hello, Mr. Tucker. This one is special for you. One of the rooms has a tiger, another has a lady, and the third is empty. All right. Okay, and what's the deal with that? Well, if you choose the tiger, you die. If you choose the lady, who happens to be, OMG, it's Firefox, you get freedom and her. And if I choose the empty room? Well, then you are free, but the king is ordered to behead Firefox if you choose the empty one. So I'm pretty sure this guy and Firefox are lovers. So basically, if you get the empty one, you're free, but your girlfriend dies. Which sucks hardcore. Alright, so how do I know which room to choose? Just give it to me straight, Gilbert. The sign on the door of the room with the lady is true, the sign on the door of the tiger is false, and the empty room could be either true or false. I hope you don't get tuckered out by this problem. I'm already tuckered out. I am, like, this is not going particularly well. You know, I'm going to try the buttons again. I feel like maybe they're going to help me this time. Nope, never mind. The buttons were a lie. All right, so the sign with the lady is true, the sign with the tiger is false, and the empty room could be either. All right, this room is empty. If the lady were in here, then the sign would be true, but that leads to a contradiction. So this door is not the one we want to go through. The lady is not in here. All right, if the lady were in this one, the tiger is in room three. We'd have to assume that's true. The tiger's in here, which makes this false. Room one is empty. And this room is empty. Could be true or false. I think... If we assume the lady is in here, we get no illogical conclusion, so I'm thinking this is probably the one, but we do need to examine this one. If the lady is in here, it means room one is empty. And that means this is empty, which makes this true. But that means the tiger is in here. The tiger is in room three. That would be false, but... Okay, so wait, it seems like actually both of these seem to work out okay. Alright, what if the tiger is in this room? If the tiger is in this room, that means that room one is not empty. And if this is not empty, that means that this is false, which means that the lady would have to be in here, which we already determined can't happen. And then that would make this the empty one, I guess. But let's try this one. Okay, how'd I do this? If the tiger is in this one, if this is also false, then I'm going... No, wait. Wait, I said with the tiger, so maybe this is the one. Let's see, if I put the tiger in this room, the tiger's in room three would mean the tiger is not in room three. And if the tiger isn't in room three, then the tiger would have to... Okay. I'm basically trying to go through all the possibilities. Why does my brain do this? All right. Think, Kelsey. Think hard. Okay, if we assume the tiger is in room three, is in here, that means that the tiger is not in room three. Which is fine, but we're assuming the tiger is here. And the tiger's not there. That's pretty logical. So if this is not the tiger, this is either empty or it's the lady. Room one is empty, so this is either true or maybe true. This room empty is either true or maybe true. I mean, one is the lady and one is the empty one. Well, geez, I am having one heck of a time logicking my way through this. All I know is that the lady is not in this one. So room one, that would mean this has to be the lady, which would make it true. Room one is empty. That would also work, I think. These ones both seem good to me. Like, it's not this one, but I'm, like, stuck between these two. The lady's in here, the tiger's in room three. Wait a minute. No, it can't be this one, because the tiger isn't... If the lady's in here, that means that this is true, the tiger's in room three. If the tiger's in room three, that means this is false. Room one is empty, but if the lady's here... And the tiger's here, this has to be empty. So that means this one actually does lead to a contradiction. This one here is the one we want. If the lady's in here, room one is empty. That's true. This room is empty is also true. We know it's true. And that would mean the tiger's in here. The tiger's in room three is false. I think that this one is the one we actually need. Horrible! Okay, I think we're doing good. The king is... he's unhappy. All three prisoners solved it! We are beasting it today. Well, we only have one more trial to go. But this time, I'll really give the prisoner a run for his money. The rules may have changed. Please talk to Gilbert for new updates. All right, Sparkle's trial. We just have one more. If we can beat this one, we have 100% at stake here. If we can beat this one, we're going to beast it. Oh my gosh, there's nine? What torment is this? How could you do such an awful thing? Look. How many? Oh, jeez. Gilbert, what is the meaning of this? My brain hurts already and I haven't even read everything yet. Wow. There are a lot of doors. And a lot of people. Hi, Sparkles. You will notice nine rooms. Only one room has a lady and the other eight each contain either a tiger or are empty. The sign on the door containing the lady is true. The signs on the doors with rooms... with tigers are false, and the signs on the doors of the empty rooms can either be true or false. Okay, I can still pick the empty door and live. Sweet. I wouldn't choose the empty room. If you go free, the king has sentenced your buddy Jerry the Slime to death. No, not Jerry. No, I love slimes. Okay, right. Empty door is a big no. I think I'd rather take the tiger, to be perfectly honest. It's better I die than Jerry. Oh, no. Oh, where do I even start? There's so many rooms! Alright, I'll give you some help. First off, if part of a sign is false and part is true, the whole sign is false. Also, you would need to know if... you would need to know if room 8 is empty or not. Gilbert whispers to Captain Sparkles if room 8 is empty or not. Is it empty or... or not. Okay. The 1/9 chance is really bad, and I don't even know where to start. Gilbert, bro. So where's the... where... so you'd need to know if room 8 is empty or not, but... G- Gilbert whispers to Captain Sparkles if room 8 is empty or not, but is it empty or not? I mean, answer the question, dude. All right, guys, here's the deal. I'm going to see if I can work this out. I'm going to get back to you guys, and we'll see if that actually happens. I have a terrible feeling that this is going to go horribly wrong for either myself or poor Jerry. But we have no choice. We're trapped in here for the rest of eternity. Okay, guys, I thought about this for, like, at least a good half hour. I wrote it down on paper and everything. I stared at it until my brain ached. But honestly, I don't really know. Like, honestly, he's right. If he would have actually told me whether or not room 8 is empty or not, then I might have been able to figure this out, but it never actually says whether it's empty or not. So I had to make a few assumptions about what things meant and operate under the assumption that room 8 has a tiger. Assuming all my assumptions were correct, I've arrived at the conclusion that lucky number 7 is the way to go. If I made even one mistake anywhere throughout the process, then either me or Jerry is going to die. But I'm going with room 7. I think I died. Okay, so clearly, sad job to have to bury people. Alright, so clearly, guys, I made an error in there somewhere, because that was absolutely brain-bending. Like, I don't even know. Charles Memorial fell on his shovel. Okay, so basically, guys, it looks like I ended up dying. Okay, guys, funny news. I was actually right after all. Every assumption I made was a complete boss assumption. Basically, my problem is I never failed on any of the other levels, so I didn't know what failure looked like. I figured that ending up in a cemetery was a horrible thing, and I probably messed something up. But I decided I was going to go back and see if I could figure out what the right choice was, and it turned out that after trying all the other ones, the one I chose actually gave the best outcome. So I'm just going to show you guys really quickly what might have happened if I'd actually chosen the wrong ones. Like, I believe 1 was incorrect. Yes, that would have put me here, where Jerry is, and they would have dropped him into some lava to die from negligence. That is bad. That means that's what would happen if I chose an empty room. Oops. Now, if I chose one like this, this is what would have happened if I'd have chosen a tiger room. As you can see, the tiger will come and murder me very quickly. He's not actually that good at his job, but I would have died eventually. And the thing is, either way, I would have ended up in the cemetery. So it turns out this is just the end place. So guys, I thought I was horribly wrong, and I was like all disappointed, but I actually got it right. I can't believe that I got it right. I worked so hard and it actually paid off. Like, I wasn't at all sure. And like I said, I don't know how much I actually edited out of me complaining about being wrong, but I actually made a lot of assumptions and I wasn't sure if I was getting all of those right, but it turns out that they weren't too bad. So basically, this is just kind of where I guess you get to see who dies. Like, right here it says, rest in peace, Captain Sparkles, slain by tiger. So if I'd have gotten a tiger level, I would have had that. If I'd have gotten an empty one, Jerry the Slime Memorial, burned from neglect, that would be here. So basically, I just tested out all of the fails. And actually has a fail counter, guys, but it turns out I did not fail whatsoever. I got 100% like a complete beast. So I hope you guys definitely enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more fun stuff like this. Because I got so many views on my last puzzle video, I decided to do another puzzle map. So definitely leave some more support if you want to keep seeing these. And if you don't want to see any more puzzle maps for some reason, just go ahead and say so, and I will definitely take that into consideration. Also, go ahead and leave a comment of what you thought of this map and any other maps that you would like to see me play, because I, like, never get any suggestions, but if I do, I will definitely take them into consideration and probably play the maps that you suggest at some time during my existence. Unless I die tomorrow, then it's probably not going to happen, but I apologize for that. Anyway, the one other thing that I would like to say, and I'm saying this on all my videos now, is that if you decide you hate my video so much that you need to leave a dislike on it, that's fine. Your opinion is legit, and I accept that, but please kindly also leave a comment letting me know what it is that you disliked about the video so that I can fix it in the future, because I strive for quality. I want you guys to enjoy this content, so if there is any reason you're not enjoying it, please just let me know, and I promise I will do everything within my power to get that fixed for the upcoming videos. And that is all I have for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed the map, and I will see you all next time. Goodbye!